Good afternoon. We are students from the IPC High School. Today we are going to interview Diego Peralta. He is an engineer in systems of informatics and computing. And we are from the TP1 first. We are from the first year of baccalaureate today. And we are going to do an interview about technology and children.
If it's okay, let's start with the questions. May you tell us about yourself?
Okay, hi everyone. My name is Diego Peralta. I am a computer science professional since 2012. I have worked in software development mainly. Now I am working in my company. I am the CEO of a company of technology. Well, it's a software development company. And we are dedicated to management and automation of business process. That's the improvement of the process of the enterprises that are our clients. And we are developing software for them.
Okay, thank you. Now we are going to start with the questions. Okay, how does technology affect children's development?
I think that most of the effects of technology are positive. For example, in the school fields, it's easier to find free information, for example, in many fields, mainly related to education and science. In communications, are easier, for example, to hold business meetings between people in different parts of the world. Even this conversation, for example, we are using a software to communicate us, and then we can talk about many things. And I think that the technology has these effects, and for me are good. The children, for example, can use this software to try to for example, receive education, for example.
In your opinion, do you think that the technology is bad for kids?
Of course not. The technology and the use of technology tools support the development of the, for example, new abilities and skills that allow complex concepts to understood easily for kids. Then I think that the bad use of technology is bad for kids, because if you are using bad the tools that are providing for the technology, of course you do bad things, and I think that it's not bad. The bad use of technology or the bad application of the tools provided by the technology are bad.
Okay, the next question is, how many hours do you think that a kid should spend on electronic devices?
I think that there should be a time limit. I don't know, the technology is used for us in our entire life, in every second. For example, the using of smartphones, the using of laptops, or for example, the words that you are wearing. Then not should limit this time. I think that you must balance this time to for example, together with physical activities.
So, do you think that technology has changed for good?
Yes, of course, because the technology is thinking to do our life easier than if you use the tools provided by technology. Of course, this change has good results for us.
Okay. It's true that the continuous use of technology is harmful, and why?
Harmful. I would not think that the continued use of technology is harmful. I would rather believe that the incorrect use of it will be harmful. For example, if you use the internet, for example, to try to hack the user and password of your partner, obviously you are causes harmful for them. Or for him, then I don't think that the continued uses of technology is in fact harmful. I think that the people must be instructed in these fields. For example, the correct use of technology, the correct times to use technology. For example, in entertainment, if you try to see videos, for example, in softwares like YouTube or TikTok, it's good if you are using for periods that not are the same time, not at the same time in your times of classes or your college time.
So, do you think that there could be a possibility that technology does not contain harmful components for children?
In technology, as in everything, there are obvious limitations that must be respected by adults and children. Obviously, children are more vulnerable, and have different visions of the use of technology. And its field of application, there will be components that will be harmful for them, and that's the reason that we try to restrict the access to certain of technologies. But the possibility of the technology that contain harmful components for childs, for kids, for adults is obviously present, as in everything.
Are the new generations capable of using better the electronic devices?
Of course. Of course, because the current generations creating or are developing new tools or new technologies to the use of the next generations, because they are the responsibles to create in future new technologies. And in general, all the companies that are developing technology think in the improve of the tools of the products that they are creating, and this improve is the responsibility of the next generation. Then they are obviously capable.
So to conclude, overall, technology is good for children because it helps to create new skills and also helps to reduce distances between people. There are some softwares, as Zoom, that help us to receive education, but always we have to give it a good use of technology and have limits about how to use technology. Thank you, Mr. Peralta, for the interview.
I actually would like to add something, Mr. Peralta, if it's okay, okay? Finally, you know, one of the main objectives of this interview is to advise parents what to do in order to control the use of technology, of course, the bad use of technology, specifically in children, because when we talk about teenagers, sometimes it's out of our hands, like I would say mostly, because, you know, you use that stuff better than adults even. But what about children? You know, what can you advise parents in order to have a better control of technology in children specifically?
Children are, for us, for the adults, our main preparation. For example, we need to carry them to use the technology by our example. For example, if I am using my cell phone all day, obviously I can't to tell to the boys or children that not use the cell phone. Then I think that the example is the better way to teach them.
To be a role model for them. Exactly. Mr. Peralta, thank you very much. You really have helped us a lot, okay? Especially to these students with the project that they are trying to develop towards a blog and a flyer that is part of this project. It is actually a learning-based project that they are developing through different subjects in the APC High School. So thank you very, very much. Guys, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.